So this will be your new assignment, and so this is basically what we have learned in the previous class, the word pair. So when you look at two words, I have already told you, we have to put an of in between these two words. Evad Melek. So when you look two nouns coming together, the group of two nouns, I already told you, it is actually, I think I can put a sentence here. Yeah, Evad Melek. So how do we translate? Slave of a king. Because see, Evad is slave and Melek is king. Slave of a, since this is not definite, you can put a indefinite article, a slave of a king, right? So this is same for everything. This is number two. This is number one. This is for number one, a slave. And Evad Hamelek. Evad Hamelek. So I already told you, if the definite article comes for the second, the definite article comes on the second word of the word pair, the whole sentence will be a definite word pair sentence. So in that case, how do we translate? Where should I put? Maybe I'll put it here. Number two. Evad Hamelek, the slave of the king. Okay, the slave of the king. I hope you can understand the difference. Okay, and this is the same for all the other word pairs. You can go through the vocabulary chart and you can work on your own, right? So that is one thing, and I'm going to go back. Maybe just hold on for a minute. Right. The next thing is, I think I forgot one more homework here. Yeah, these are some sentences relating to word pair. Again, if you look at this first sentence, Being Hayish Zakar Yet Hamayim Bemoav. Okay, Being Hayish Zakar Yet Hamayim Bemoav. Being Hayish, the sun is what? Men, son of a man, okay, son of a man. Being Hayish, the daughter of the man, Zakar, remembered, the daughter of the man, remembered, yet Hamayim, Mayim is what? Water. Remembered the water, in Moab. Okay, so the translation will be something like, the son of the man, remembered the waters in Moab. Right. Okay. The son of the man remembered the waters in Moab. So this is something, these are very simple sentences. The only thing you need to understand the word pair concept and word pair structure and try to supply these kind of, especially the of. Okay, don't forget that one. So likewise, you need to supply all the finish all the homework, right? Let us go back again, and now for this morning, we are going to learn something more about the word pair. Okay, this is again continuation of the word pair, but what we have learned so far is word pair singular. Okay, word pair singular. Now we will be seeing a word pair plural. Okay, plural form. How the word pair changes in the plural form, and again I'm going to share you another chart for you. Maybe by this class, or maybe by the after this class. But you can now let us read these vocabularies before we go further. Now let us read these vocabularies. The first vocabulary we will start here. Ohel, ohalim, ohel. Okay, ohel, ohalim, ohel. So now, in hereafter, you will see this kind of a small dash here. Okay, small so which is nothing but the word pair. Okay, whenever there is a word pair, if the word pair comes, this noun doesn't change any vowels. So that is what here is indicating. So whenever a word pair is there, there won't be any change in this noun. But let us see if there is any change happening anywhere. See here, we will see. We will see that later. So ohel, ohalim, ohel means tent. Okay, and zakhav. Okay, zakhav, zakhav, gold, gold. Okay, and these two are masculine nouns. Don't forget that also. Whenever you are memorizing vocabularies, along with the vocabulary, also try to remember whether it is a masculine or feminine noun. And Yaakov, okay, Jacob. We know that, right? We know Yaakov is Jacob. So some of the translations from when it is translated from Hebrew to, especially in Tamil language, many of the names sound similar to Hebrew, right? The Yaakov in Tamil also, it is something like Yaakob, and I'm sure even in Telugu or Malayalam, these are very, very similar. The sound is very similar. But when it goes to English, see, the total thing is changed. Jacob. So this is something we need to note. But I'm not saying because of this one, the other English translations are not good, and the other, the regional translations are better. But just for you to observe how the translation changes things. And Koh, Koh is thus. Koh, thus. Kohen, okay, Kohen, Kohanim, Kohen, priest. Just see the difference here. Koh, Kohen, only the newness at the end. Just relate these two and we can remember. Right. And Keli, okay, Keli, Kelim, Keli, okay, Keli, Kelim, Keli, vessel or dish, something like that. Okay, Midwar, okay, Midwar, wilderness or desert. Midwar, Midbar, okay, not war, Midbar, desert or wilderness. Makom, Makomot, Makom, okay, Makom, Makomot, Makom, place. Some kind of place. Nefesh, Nefesh, Nefashot, okay, Nefashot, Nefesh, soul or person. Odd. Okay. Odd. Again, still another, yet more. Ayin. Yenayin. Yeyin. Okay. See, here is what we need to notice. In the here, for this noun, the regular noun is ayin. There is a patak here, there is a hirak here. Hirak, I mean hirak here. But here, see the word pair form changes actually. So here it becomes sereyod, yeyin, okay, yeyin. So that we need to take note when we are translating. And panim, face, panim, face. Rachel, okay, Rachel, Rachel. Sar, Sarim, Sar, okay. Commander chief, you know, you can relate this one. When you see somebody higher official, what we do, sir, right? Hello, sir. Yes, sir. Something like that. So, sir. Okay, sir is Sarim. Sir is commander or chief, right? So, these are some new vocabularies. Let me read it once again for you. If you have missed out something, please take note of that. Ohel, ohali, ohel, tent. Zakhav, gold. Yaakov, Jacob. Ko, thus. Kohen, Kohanim, Kohen, priest. Keli, Kelim, Keli, vessel, implement, dish. Midbar, Midbar, wilderness or desert. Makom, Mekomoth, Mekom, place. Nefesh, Nefashoth, Nefesh, soul or person. Od, again, still another eight more. Ayin, Yenayim, Yeyin, I. Panim, face or faces. Both singular and plural. Rachel, Rachel. Sar, Sarim, Sar, commander or chief. Right. So now let us continue with the plural endings. We already know the plural endings, right? Im, mostly im ending and oth ending. So let us get back to the class and we will try to see something. So the word pair plural with im ending. Im, when I say im ending, this is what I mean. So yeah, let us take this word anashim. Anashim. So anashim is the plural form of people. Okay. Im is people, anashim. So if it comes in the verb pair form, see the changes happening. So this is one small word pair with plural form. Anse. See, here we should not pronounce this. This seva, because this is not a, this is a silent seva. So, Anse Mitzrayim. Anse Mitzrayim. So, Anashim has changed to Anse. Why? Because of the word pair. So, how do we translate? Mitzrayim is already a definite noun. I already told you the places and the people's name will be already definite. So, the people of Mitzrayim, Egypt. The people of Egypt, right? So, this is one example that you can take note of that. And one more example we can see here. Banim, sons. Banim, sons. So, Bene Mishpacha. Bene Mishpacha. So how do we translate? So this is not a definite noun. So Bene Mishpacha. So Banim has changed to Bene. Okay, so you need to see this is plural. So this is the plural form of sons in the word pair. Whenever it comes to the word pair, it changes in this way. So sons of a family. Sons of a family. Right? So this is what happens in the im ending. And so yeah, now I have prepared the chart for you. Let me share it to the classroom and we can check it once. We can check it once again. Until then, please hold on. Okay, so now here you can see the word pair with the plural form. Okay, so I can help you understand that. Yes. Now, if you look at this chart here, av, avot, avi. Okay, av, avot, avi. Avot. So Av is father, Avot is fathers, Avi is the word pair singular form, Avot is word pair plural form. Okay, and Adon, Adonim, Adon. So for singular and plural, for both the word pair form is Adon. Okay, and Ohel, Ohalim. Ohel, Ahale. See, Ahale. You don't need to say Ahale. Ahale, okay, ahale. So ohel, ohalim, ohel, ahle. See, for the tense. So if you see a word pair for tense, a word pair form for tense in plural, tense in plural, ahale. See, this is actually ohalim, but it changes to ahale. Okay, that is what you need to look carefully. And ah. And ahim, ahi, yehi. See, yehi or ahi. Ah, brother, ahim, brother, and ahi, brother of, and ahe, brothers of. Okay. Is, man, anasim, men or people. Is, man of, anas, anse, man, men of, people of. Okay. Eret, land, arasot, land. Eret, land of. So this small dash, I'm telling you again, it tells about the word part. Eret, land of, arasot, land of. So here, actually, Arasot, it is very similar. Only the first two vowels changes a little bit. So that's not a big thing. Isha, woman. Nasim, women. Iset, yeset. Okay, yeset, woman of. Nese, women of. Okay. Behema, animal. Behemoth, animals. Behema, animal of. Okay, animal of. So likewise, you can go through the whole chart and you can use it for your further translations. Okay. And is there anything that I need to teach you now? Yeah, so this is where the word pair ends. So what you are going to do is mostly you need to keep this chart, these charts along with you when you are translating, so that when you get familiarized with the vocabulary, you can easily follow it. Okay, right. Now let's get into one more lesson and we are going to stop from there. Right. Let's come back to class. So the word he, the word he, sometimes used to indicate direction. Okay, direction. Direction means the path or direction in which the in which somebody has to go or something like that. Let me give you some example. Eretz. What is that? Land. Right. Eretz is land. And Arsa, okay, Eretz Arsa. So here you need to see this one sade, final sade, this one is regular sade. Okay, so this actually these three letters are very same, only we have added a he at the end. So what that means? Land word. So the translation become land word, or in another words we can also say toward a land. people won't say like this towards and land. Instead of that, we can use land word. Okay, direction to go towards the land, towards the land. Okay, towards the land. So that is what the function of K. Sometimes it is used in this way. So you need to be very clear about the vocabulary. So only if you know these three root letters, RS, you can understand RSA is something related to direction. And otherwise I will also give some familiar example. Jerusalem. Okay. Jerusalem. So Jerusalem. And if it comes in the with the direction marker, so it is Jerusalem. Okay, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, okay, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, or see, there is only one K is added. So now, how the translation comes is toward Jerusalem. Okay, toward Jerusalem. And anything else? One more example and I'm going to stop. Ha ha. Ha ha. What? The mountain. The mountain. So Hahara. So there is a K added here. So now the meaning is toward the mountain. Okay, basically, if you see a he at the end of a regular noun, please take note of that. That may be telling you about the direction. So, and most of the time, you have to look at the whole sentence. So only based on that, you have to decide how the translation goes on. Okay. So I am repeatedly telling you how difficult is the translation section. So I hope you can follow it up. Maybe in the next class, I will tell you about the next class when it is. And